And the protest was ignited by the shooting of James Boyd in the Albuquerque foothills. Boyd was illegally camping there and was shot March 16th after a long standoff with APD. The department says officers first fired flashbangs at Boyd, then tasers, and sent the dog in twice before using real bullets, killing him.
Police and jail records show James Boyd had a long criminal history dating back more than a decade.
And those records also show he was also in and out of the mental health system. Action 7 reporter Nancy Laughlin talked with the governor about the state of mental health.
Well, we have done multiple reports about the backgrounds of the officers involved in the Boyd shooting. We've also reported on James Boyd's background as well. He was a man who, according to multiple police, jail reports, and court records, struggled with mental illness.
He was a man without a family, but since his death 2 weeks ago, some people in the community have embraced James Boyd, a man who lived on the streets, but also spent a lot of time in and out of jails and mental health facilities. According to court records and our partners at the Albuquerque Journal, Boyd's run-ins with New Mexico law enforcement began in 2002. That January, in Las Cruces, he was charged with battery on a peace officer. In May, he was sent to the state psychiatric hospital in Las Vegas for evaluation. January 2003, Boyd was found competent to stand trial. July 2003, Boyd was sent back to Las Vegas for another evaluation. February 2004, he's found incompetent and authorities order continued treatment. Later that year, he's returned to the Doña Ana County Jail, then involuntarily committed to the mental health facility. The case is dismissed. March 2005, Boyd is arrested for assaulting a man on Civic Plaza, telling him, quote, "I am God and I want to hurt you." He's taken to jail. 4 months later, the charges are dropped. July 2007, he's arrested for disorderly conduct for refusing to leave a fire station, telling firefighters he's a government agent and wants to send them to hell. He's taken to jail where he punches a corrections officer. April 2009, Boyd gets into a fight outside a homeless shelter and slices a man's face multiple times with a box cutter. For the next 4 years, he's in and out of the mental health facility and MDC. But eventually, James Boyd ended up back on the streets until his final run-in with the law March 16th. We asked the governor if she thought it was time for lawmakers to revisit Kendra's Law, a law that requires some mentally ill patients to take medicine, seek therapy, or both.
I think it's too soon to say that what's going to happen with a session because we need to know what happened and if that was a contributing factor or not.
Now, in 2006, Kendra's Law made its way to the Roundhouse, but the proposed legislation did not pass. In 2010, former APD officer Carol Oleksik urged lawmakers to revisit it again. In 2003, Oleksik was shot in the head with her own gun while trying to arrest a man who suffered from mental illness.
Kendra's Law was named after a woman in New York who was pushed in front of a subway by a man suffering from mental illness.
The protest